5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Broadcasting worldwide from Paindonium Studios in Cornwall, this is the Wal of Paine show on Phluid FM.
That wasn't bad, was it? That wasn't bad, and it's very much for this sort of weather, isn't it? It's very sort of Hawaiian with your loud shirt this evening.
Well, I know, I'm trying to keep the noise down.
It's like Magnum PI without the moustache.
And apparently we're all out of sync, Steve. I don't know whether we're in sync now or whether...
Was that Justin Timberlake in sync?
Oh, NSYNC. Whether we're like Thunderbirds.
I don't know, probably.
Hello. All right,
I think the sound is okay.
Yeah.
Hopefully, it's just we're
a
couple of jerks out here.
Jerking out. What a cracking opener.
That's
with
not
the
bad,
bug,
is it?
I
forgot to do this, didn't
the
I?
The bug club was a little opening tune as well, Steve.
That's good.
Catch it. Yeah, some summer number.
Cracking tunes already on the go this evening, for sure.
Hmm.
What do you know? What's occurring?
Well, what's occurring is, tomorrow night, me and Andrea and Anthony and Tracy and Claire are going to see Jack Johnson, which is why I thought I'd put him straight away in the mix. We're going down to the Eden Project.
That big old Cornish greenhouse.
It's absolutely brilliant. You been?
No!
What?
I've driven past a number of times.
Well, never been?
I've never been. I've been past the St Austell Pyramid.
Yeah.
Not been into...
The Cornish Alps, they call them.
Do they? We get a bit of snow down there.
Yeah. Cornish Alps, all that.
Fair enough.
Run off from the quarry. Oh, Eden Project, fantastic. Highly recommend it to anybody. Been there a couple of times before to see things, obviously, and then a live act went down about 18 months ago and saw the script.
Ooh,
fantastic.
Good.
They were brilliant. Unfortunately, that was June, and it wasn't a balmy night in June that this kind of radio always get when they get together.
Who?
It was, I don't know.
Who?
I don't know.
You said balmy?
It was a rainy night in June, but it was still good fun.
Rainy night in Georgia?
Yeah. Rainy night in Eden.
Oh, we stopped jerking on there.
Oh. Careful.
We haven't tried a tipple yet, have we? Got a few tipples this evening.
Oh my God, what's Lizzie coming with this?
We've got some choice tipples this evening. This is my brother North Plums.
Is it?
He's bottled it.
Has he?
We can decant it a bit later. You have get a nose on that. You'll be a fire starting after that. That's a bit, ooh, I won't get your eyes near it.
Isn't it?
You lose your sight.
And I brought around it, but what's this? Lizzie.
That is Domestos.
Mrs. Prout.
Kills all known germs.
Has just made me try this as I was going to the van.
Oh, did she?
And I nearly fell down the steps.
Yeah, yes.
Have a go on that.
That is, I think it's elderflower.
That's not what she told me.
Is it not?
No, and I can't even read the label. It's in, whatever's in there seems to take the ink off.
There's only glass left. We shall be imbibing.
We shall.
At some homebrew a bit later.
We shall.
And what else we got for tipple of the week?
We've got Hawkstone Lager from Jeremy Clarkson.
There's none in the country.
There isn't.
There's no, we've got it.
We've got an auction, couldn't we? Yeah, you can't buy this apparently until the 3rd of July.
Wow.
Clarkson let all of it go to the Formula One racing team, apparently, that
he
got brewed.
Yes.
So it's not what you know, it's who you know, but there's a story attached to this, which we will sell.
Excellent.
Which we can. I'm sure there's a story
attached to this, but I'm not sure I want to know it. There's many lost evenings attached to that stuff.
And of course, it's Glastonbury this weekend.
It is. So we've got a whole load.
And we've got some friends at Glastonbury, haven't we? Friends of the show,
indeed.
We've got a Glastonbury.
We'll play those a bit later on.
Yeah.
What do you fancy next? What's the next track?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I chose the two openers. So, Steve, you know, we are an equal opportunities employer.
See, what I was going to kick off with this evening.
Oh, sorry. Right, go on.
What was going to kick off with? A bit of Stranglers.
Oh!
A bit of Floyd on the floor. See, you got the tipples.
Absolutely. A bit of the Stranglers.
Let's have some of that.
Soon the Stranglers live as well.
Why wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Priceless, oh, my God, what a tune that is. Took us back to the days of... Remember Keith Floyd?
He loved. He was a Stranglers family. Keith Floyd. He died in the years ago. Keith Floyd.
I'm not surprised. He was looking at the bottles. And
yeah, I know. Oops. Maybe he had some of your brother-in-law's plums.
Might have done that. That would do it every single time. Let's
flambate
behind us there.
Just talking about there's a fantastic on the 30th of September at the Tavistock Wharf, a fantastic Stranglers tribute band called Straighten Out.
Yes.
So we're going.
I'm going to pop blocks that one off. Definitely.
I think it's 14 quid a head or something, which you can't go wrong.
Can't grumble at that, can you? You haven't seen them live anymore, the real ones, are you? So.
No, I mean, I saw the original lineup, which was great, up in Birmingham years and years ago. But of course, sadly, we lost, Dave Greenfield a few years ago, isn't it now?
Yeah.
And then Jet Black a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
Hugh Cornwall, who said he would never
again.
never play with the Stranglers again. Great story attached to that.
It's all going that way.
I read Hugh Cornwall's autobiography, which was really interesting. But fantastic as well, because obviously they made, I mean, Golden Brown was United Artists' biggest tune at the time. They made loads of money. I mean, the amount of albums they've made. And everybody was trying to get the Stranglers back together, but they all had a bit of a falling out. I mean, they never really got on with one another right from the start. Looking at the book and reading the book. And they wanted to get them, strangely enough, to headline. I think it was to get back to Glastonbury.
And they were like,
no. And Hugh Cornwall was like, I'm never playing with these guys again. And they said, well, look, you know, because Glastonbury, I think a lot of it is done altruistically. It's charity, sponsor. Yeah. And they said, we will pay you £1 million if you get the band back together and you come and play.
You've got to hate someone a lot to turn £1 million, haven't you?
Hugh Cornwall's response, which is absolutely brilliant, and so he's writing in his autobiography, I said to the fella, but I don't need £1 million.
You can't argue that, really, can you?
No,
you cannot.
Fancy paying somebody like Hugh Cornwall and saying you have £1 million. He's like, well, what am I going to do with that? I've already got several £1 million. Yeah. What do I need another one for?
Exactly.
So, brilliant, and I admire him. And he's gone out and done his own thing.
Yes.
With session musicians, which is very good because I've seen some of that on YouTube.
It's all good stuff. It's all.
Yeah.
It's not busy.
But Glastonbury, not for me these days, Steve. I don't think personally.
For me to be. I don't do camping for one thing, and always going to be. But it's supposed to be awesome this weekend, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's really, really good.
I just find that I did Reading '89 and Reading '90.
Yeah, yeah.
Kind of single stage.
Yeah.
Eight bands on, you get to see them.
It's
next
too much.
Night, eight bands on. You're paying hundreds and hundreds of pounds.
I've got.
How many bands can you physically see?
I've got the lineup on here.
Okay,
I don't
know
how many there are. I'm still scrolling. I mean, it's ridiculous.
And that's probably besides all the side tent acts.
Exactly. I mean, they are going, they're dragging the bottom of the barrel thing towards the end on here, but.
Yeah, look at that. How many of those can you see for you?
I don't know.
£2,000 or whatever it is to go these days. You can just listen to it here.
The interestingly named Fanny Lumsden.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I have a bit of that.
Have you got any Fanny Lumsden queued up?
I might have.
Shall we have a look, see if she's on Spotify? Let's have a look and see Fanny Lumsden.
I was actually praising this show, trying to do a show for a change, and I couldn't.
Who's headlining?
I didn't put it on.
This year?
Well, Alan John's supposed to be finishing, isn't he?
Oh,
he's supposed to be.
Christ, is he?
That is the end, then. Of his final farewell ever tour. Watch out, Roz is after you.
Oh.
Bill. Yeah, they come to get so Elton John for crimes against singing and
crimes against music, yeah,
and hair pieces.
So he's not playing anymore after Glastonbury.
No, not.
So every what cloud and all that.
What a shame. Yes.
Oh yeah, terrible crying shame that is.
Yeah, no, there's some good acts.
I love Elton John.
Imagine.
Massive fan.
Lana Del Rey's up there. Lewis Capaldi, if he can get around to doing it. Lizzo.
Arctic Monkeys.
Lizzo's
good.
I thought Cat Stevens was dead. Well, clearly he's not. Wheel him on. Like,
let's Google. No, he isn't. No,
like,
he isn't dead.
Burnies, isn't it?
Well,
just
you could.
Wheel him on.
Well, you could do. I mean, yeah, maybe he is dead.
Who else you got? Roses. But they are also playing the Hyde Park gig.
Oh, okay.
That I went to BST, British Summer Time in the Park, where it was called, which I saw the Stones at last year. They were good. Oh. Lana Del Rey, Lizzo, Queen Stone Age, Blondie, Rick Astley, okay.
Royal Blood,
Candy Staton, Sparks. They're weird.
Okay, they are weird. I'll tell you who is there, though, Steve. It's the Scribes.
Indeed.
Friends of the show, Johnny and Sean, who I went down to see not so long ago, actually, in Falmouth. And talk about crowd engagement.
Oh, I bet.
Oh, from the start, literally, all the way through, they had the crowd. I mean, it's a cliche.
Eating out of their hands.
They did. Absolutely fantastic. And such a lovely couple of guys. Really engaging, really nice guys. They've already given us a shout out from Glastow.
Well, I think it's time to play a track in that case.
Shall we?
Let's go for it.
Mighty Mighty.
Say a big violation, but you know, when I go on the board and try to go on that thing. That thing, but if you're there, if you're there, the business, you know. So I'm going to have a cool one for the shelter and place in charge. I must, man. I see it. I see it. I see it. I see it. I'm on one of them times that I can't remember what to give a fuck.
Mighty, mighty, rise like a helicopter, still a vote by telling whoppers. They done drop a lot of bollocks on these kids, trying to profit from the rifts in each follow in the splits. Man, our whole fucking politics is rigged. Up to Zorro with the mic, slicing S's on your shit. Sit down up all your blessings as I bless this. Get ready for the next shit, the mess that we are left with. Restless, caught up in a courtroom full of jesters. Dressed as the next best thing we can invest in. F this, put your cross where you hate at least. We lost all our faith in these party-led fakeries. But it won't change, man, the lies are insurmountable. Where everybody's starting shy and no one's held accountable.
Mighty, mighty, rise like a tower. Try to the power, but them can't take the power at all. Roll up a lion or two that give a noise of a sound while losing his future. Mighty, mighty, rise like a tower. Try to the power, but them can't take the power at all. Roll up a lion or two that give a noise of a sound while losing his future.
Fresh out the void, it's the crew you can trust. Check your boy telling you to raise your voice as a must. It's an ironclad position, you don't listen enough. There's no time to test your mettle when you're playing with rust. Past tense is past tense, hasty over compliments. Lost the words that the wind rush documents. We hear you government, go home, that's what you meant. Watch from dust just to watch you profiting. Deal for cup and make a politician bore. Roar, I will be a thorn in the side like metal sores. No horse, we're chasing a white whale. Walk for talk, I'm running my mouth well. Cross for ground that men and guys sporting in Ezekiel. Settle sentiment scores 1-0 to Israel. Pigs, kettle, meddling kids ready to meet jail. Heads high till we greet justice for the sweet smell.
Mighty, mighty, rise like a tower. Try to the power, but them can't take the power at all. Roll up a lion or two that give a noise of a sound while losing his future. Mighty, mighty, rise like a tower. Try to the power, but them can't take the power at all. Roll up a lion or two that give a noise of a sound while losing his future.
The righteous stay complicit in the history of violence. Enlightened take positions that resist against the tyrants. I've been claiming both in the boardroom with papyrus. When I gas the words of flyer like the sky without a pilot. Swinging arms, I place my palms upon the pious. The irony is rich, but the touch is never Midas. Why raise a fist of your enlistment is in private? Resist the tricks and listen, or the bigotry that binds.
The truth is slow burn, lies are hella quick. Minds already set, divisive rhetoric. Dreams are derelict, know your enemies. Like who the fuck chose that those are terrorists? Trick perspective, shit lips dripped with excrement. Still kiss the requisite amount of ass. Get ahead, class wars and nepotists. All borders separatists and truth lying buried under treasure, it's sick.
Mighty, mighty, rise like a tower. Try to the power, but them can't take the power at all. Roll up a lion or two that give a noise of a sound while losing his future. Mighty, mighty, rise like a tower. Try to the power, but them can't take the power at all. Roll up a lion or two that give a noise of a sound while losing his future.
Another quality tune there for you and for me, Neil. Absolutely. Well, not from you, from the Scribes. I've never heard you rap.
I was going to say I haven't played a quality tune in my life, Steve. So
let's not worry about that.
But we're just having a little bit of an off-air chat there about that Titanic submarine, aren't we? And I think this is the first time, you know, when Google predicts what you're searching for, and I only got as far as tit, and and you can imagine what Google's making of that, but no, straight to the Titanic submarine.
Not your normal search.
No. Straight to the Titanic submarine. It was on tit.
Speaking of, so we're about Alan Johns now, weren't we?
Speaking of tits. Yeah, absolutely.
Not Sandy. Sandy's come on and said, I wonder who Alan John is putting on stage with him. Quick as a flash.
His carer. certainly not. What's his name? Torpin.
Is he still alive? I'll tell you, we're sort of
Why are you thinking everybody's dead tonight?
They're old, aren't they? They're old.
Oh, they are old. I mean, I don't even know why Elton John is even dead, still going. Barry Torpin.
Oh, that's him, the writer.
Yeah. Now, we've also got Steve tonight, because it was a runaway success last week. We're having a phone-in.
Really?
It was a runaway train last week.
It was worse than that Titanic submarine.
Was it really?
It it sunk quicker than that, descending 2 miles down to the murky depths.
Imagine that.
No.
No, let's not.
I mean, to be fair, so I think the submarine is probably about as big as this studio. Probably a bit narrower. The rent's about 2 meters by...
Is that all?
It's about this bit, and there's five of them in there.
And they've gone down to view the Titanic.
Yeah. And now they're part of the Titanic. There's this urban myth, there's this rumour going around, this conspiracy theory, that it's all been plotted out by James Cameron to make another film.
Ah.
Because you can't have Titanic 2, can you? Because the Titanic sunk, and that's in there.
Would you remember...
The Titanic 5, not the famous 5.
Timmy the dog.
With less Timmy the dog.
Do you remember the film Raise the Titanic that they tried to do?
Vaguely.
And so, yeah, I forget who it was now, and they tried to make this film, and apparently it went over budget, over budget, over budget, and at the end, the actual joke of it, the producer that was trying to make it, said in the end, never mind raising the Titanic, it reckons it would have been cheaper to lower the Atlantic.
Oh, dear me.
I mean, at least he had a sense of humour about it after they'd gone over budget.
What a thing.
Yeah.
Not a way to go.
Not a nice way to go at all.
It is too soon to start playing Submarine and Under the Sea.
Or, we'll stay. My heart will go on.
How long was that song in the charts for? That was
I don't know, 18 years.
Worse than Bryan Adams.
That was in the charts forever. What was the song, Bryan Adams?
Everything I Do, I Do.
That's
for
it. What was that from? That was from
weeks.
A movie.
Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves.
That's it. God, your memory's good.
God, dear me, mate. No, I mean...
Or was it just like repetition?
I think what it was. So, yeah, so any Kevin Costner film is notoriously long, isn't it?
Oh,
it's
yeah.
It's value for money. It's a water world. I think it's still playing somewhere.
I've not seen that.
In real time. No, don't bother.
No. I've seen JFK. That was very good.
Yes.
And I did
see... You were there, weren't you, anyway? You were on the grassy knoll at the time.
The second gunman on the grassy knoll.
In the repository.
The book depository.
That's the one.
See, that's a conspiracy right
there,
isn't
it? It's a lot about.
I saw a film on that, like a documentary, absolutely years ago, about that grassy knoll. The documentary wasn't about a grassy knoll. That would have been a bit boring.
Wouldn't it?
But the compounding evidence and whatever of the FBI involvement was... I guess it's like any conspiracy theory, isn't it? If you load it from one side...
Oh, it just keeps growing, doesn't
it? Yeah, and if you load it from another side, it was like watching that thing on Netflix about... Madeleine McCann's parents.
Oh, right.
I don't know if you saw that.
I just try to stay clear of that because...
Yeah, I know.
As sad as it is, I think they've done it... No, they've done it to death, haven't they?
Yes,
they've
absolutely done it to death. But
they shouldn't have done it, and where was that one's happened, but they're not going to find it.
But it came on Netflix, and it was obviously engineered to be like, you watch one episode and go, oh, the parents haven't possibly done it. Watch another episode, she's guilty as hell.
Yeah, yeah.
Watch another episode, oh, no, I don't think so. Another episode, that Jerry McCann's well ropey, and it was engineered, and still didn't do it at any resolution, because they've got no solution to them.
Of course not. But, talking about no subject whatsoever, how can you have a dead body smell in your boot, for Christ's sake, unless you're a farmer? You're carrying a lot of dead livestock about.
I mean, I don't know, but they said that sniffer dog went mad in the boot, didn't they? And there's
cold kebab, I reckon, personally.
I don't like the look of Kate McCann. If you had to put me up against a wall and put a gun to my head, and I would say she's as suspicious as anything. I think she looks guilty.
Yeah. Not likable. You think you'll be likable, haven't you, as well?
Yeah.
I think if you haven't got likability, you're sunk.
Yeah.
Anyway, we've been too soon.
I think that's why this show went down so well. And what I was going to say is, Steve, anyway, not that the show was a runaway success, that the phone-in quiz was a runaway success.
It was, and it's about sausages.
So we're going to have another phone-in quiz, but I said to Andrea we'll do it a little bit earlier tonight, so we're going to phone her at 7:45. And I've forgotten my... bloody dangly attachment.
We can dangle it from this, it'll work.
So we'll have to do this and we'll do a live.
You have on there on speaker that'll
you
work.
Reckon?
This is live.
You reckon your new
radio.
Mic?
It's awesome, this mic. I've turned it right down as well. So
when did this turn up then, this mic?
The other day.
So is that the old one?
Yeah. That's ropey as hell, that, don't it?
So the old one is just an SM57?
Yeah.
And this is a proper broadcasting mic.
Broadcast quality.
It is posh.
Makes sound a lot better than it had been. I have to wear a suit next time, you know?
It is posh. I'm going to take a photo of this because we'll put it up on Insta.
Yeah, fair enough. Right, let's just have some more music. What we got coming up? Let's have some Guns N' Roses.
Let's.
With a cover. I normally do covers on my show, but we'll allow this one. We play so many...
Hang on, this is your show, Steve.
Well, that's not. This is a Wall of Proud show. So
well, it's a bit of...
It's 50-50.
Well, I've got a good rant for you later.
It's just my studio.
Your rants and bants.
Indeed.
I've got a right old rant.
Let's have some of that right after.
A bit of gut and nut.
A bit of G&R. A bit of G&R, not rest and relaxation.
Not gin and tonic.
Guns and Roses.
Guns and Roses.
Plenty more of a drink to imbibe later on. No, so we've been... I think there might be a new feature coming up, Dead or Alive. Which I'm not saying... Obviously, clearly Axl Rose is still alive. Well, he is at the moment anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, not really, yeah. Faithless. So Faithless are playing.
What's his name? We just said Max.
Maxie Priest.
Yeah.
Not.
At 65, died last year.
I know.
Well, here's the thing, because you say it could be a new feature, like Dead or Alive. So many, many years ago, and this will also be a tie into Hawkstone Lager with the Squances. So our best friends, the Squances, Paul and Joey, and we go up and visit them. They're in the Cotswolds, they can have a visit us. Whenever we get together, we play a lot of cards.
Yeah.
We drink a lot
of
beer, and a lot of wine gets drunk. And we were talking years ago, this is, and somebody mentioned Jimmy Savile.
God.
And
we're going for the full gamut tonight, aren't we, Elton John, Jimmy Savile? Is it real Gary Glitter and Schofield in next?
And then Joe, I forget what the order was, but Joey was like, but he's dead. And Paul's like, he isn't. And Andrea's like, he is. And I'm like, I don't think he is. Literally, we woke up the next morning and he died. It was the
crikey.
Night before. So we're like, yes, we've killed Jimmy.
I remember you saying that.
We've killed Jimmy Savile. Literally.
He killed someone else, did not Jimmy Savile?
Yeah, the same year we got together, we had a conversation, and I can't remember who it was again now, and Joey said something like, but he's dead. And I'm like, he's not, he's alive. And Andrew's like, no, he's definitely dead. And Paul's like, no, he's definitely alive. And we woke up the next morning, and they announced that the person we'd been talking...
Yeah,
so we feel that if anybody, like a bit like voodoo, if you want anybody bumping off,
I mean,
let us know, and we'll just discuss whether they're dead or alive, and it seems to kill them.
Well, I think... famous Rolf Harris conversation, dead or alive, that clearly worked, didn't it? Well?
Absolutely. But I think you're right, Steve. Maybe we could have a feature.
That could be a feature, because I'm convinced a lot of these people are dead. Like, Cat Stevens is playing Glastonbury.
I mean, he might be dead.
It
depends on what when you... I mean, clinically dead, or...
Back to Elton John again, haven't we?
Dead from the waist up. I mean, Elton John doesn't... He hasn't really got many movable parts left, has he?
Eyebrow. You see his eyebrow? You see him do a candle in the wind.
His eyebrow was going like a bloody candle in the wind. No, I just can't get on with the bloke. I know he's phenomenally popular, globally popular.
He's just one of those people, isn't he? I think I don't know. He's sort of been there forever,
hasn't he? Hey, I bet Andrea's put us together. We'll phone her up after the next tune.
Okay.
If she's put together an Elton bloody John quiz, I will eat my... Should we give a shout out to another of our friends over at Glasto, to Andy Quick?
Exactly, why not?
He's there with the Andy Quick band. He's also there with the Land of the Giants. A picture came up on Insta with them all driving down the other day. Big ups to go into Glasto. So we're on a Glasto trip, aren't we?
We are indeed.
Bit of Red Dreads as well. This is a classic.
That is
Land of the Giants.
Tune. Where are we? Yeah, so... well, Sandy didn't... I should have been saying, Rolf is dead, or Rolf's dead. Breaking news. Rolf House is dead.
I know. I mean, great artist, though.
Yes. Yeah, you couldn't...
Controversially.
He wasn't very good at cutting him around the edges, I don't think.
No, I mean...
A bit of a problem with that.
He never could... Well, you could never work out what he was. Well, I used to love... watching Rolf paint.
I know.
He used to paint on a massive scale. with a roller and everything. And then all of a sudden, it was like a phenomenal landscape. Shame he turned out to be a kiddie fiddler.
It was, wasn't it?
Can't have everything, Steve.
Can you? Nor could he. Let's Land of the Giants. We just give him a quick name check over at Glastonbury. Let's have some of this.
Dancing with no shoes on, in the left hand, overproof from the other hands, in the hand of his woman. Loves the hot sun in his garden, he's making music made by the ocean. This for you, this for you, wherever you go, whatever you do. A warehouse on the horizon. She's here resting on a warm bosom.
In his arms I see dreadlocked children. No fear, no good reason. Satisfied in every season. This for you, I wish for you. Wherever you go, whatever you do.
Isn't bad, is it? That is good. And I hate comparing original acts, like a bit of Eloisa.
we'll have that
little
later.
Preview.
We meant to do that, just so you can see what's coming on later.
Yes, all these proper stations go, what's coming up next? We just do unannounced.
Unannounced.
I don't like comparing bands to other bands, really, because you think they're sort of copying the But that was sort of very specials, very ghost town, and a little bit of that, I don't know what the technical name for that guitar is, very sort of 70s Dasky Dutch.
Whack-a-chicka guitar, I call it.
That's the one, the whack, yeah.
I always say that if I'm ever playing with Charlie, actually that sounds wrong.
Yeah, Travol Farris again.
Or Zippy and Rainbow.
It's better than taking Charlie, I suppose.
I hope you're all playing with your wangers.
I'll never get on there, won't
I? Whenever I'm playing with Chris or Charlie, because they've both got like Craig, and I'm always like, give it a bit of whack-a-chicka-whack-a-chicka on the...
I don't know what the technical term for it is.
Right, I'm going to ring the quiz mistress. Carry on, go on.
Sandy has been on and said, Rolf is dead. Breaking news, folks, Rolf is dead. And, I think we knew that, didn't we? But apparently, he was buried at sea, wasn't he?
He was, apparently.
Yeah.
Oh!
In between two little boys.
Here we go. Now, is this Mike picking this up?
It should be.
Hello, Andrea. You are live on the Wall of Prout show.
Please do not swear.
Good evening, Neil, and good evening, Steve.
As if she would.
Is that picking it up? I can put it up there if it doesn't. Now, I forgot my plug-in widget, Andrea, so we're going to have to hold you up to the microphone. Can you hear yourself broadcasting?
You can hold me up if you like, Neil.
This is a family show. Right, Steve, we need pads.
We need pads. You got... Yeah.
Oh, hang on, but Liz is written all over that with some legal jargon.
Paper and pens.
We need paper and pen.
Have that one. I'll give you a pen so I can't.
Shall we stand Andrew on top of the bottle of plums?
I can move the microphone down.
And then we'll. There you go. Look at that.
Have that. We'll drop the mic.
The mic drops.
Where are we? We're there, aren't we?
The speaker's there. So if we move Andrew there, the look at that.
There we go. Look at that. Don't drop it off his plums.
How good is that?
We're good. We can hear ourselves in the background. Can't be bad, can it?
Oh, is that the bells kicking off now?
Yeah, I know. The bells have just kicked off.
The love of God. Bellings. Actually, quite literally, for the love of God.
Yeah. Go tell them off.
Yeah. I almost...
Campanologists.
Back to Elton again.
Indeed. Oh, that's a little queer.
Right, Andrew, have you got the door shut? Have you shut out the bells? And are we ready for a quiz?
I've shut the door. It's very hot in here. I'm now melting.
I know, it is very hot there, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a bit cool. We've got a bit of breeze coming through the studio here to see. Not too bad, is it?
We've got a ting. Oh, last orders at the bar. That's the quiz intro now. Right, what, after last week's sausage-based... What is it this week?
Mash.
Right, okay, this week is, do you know you're gay?
Do you know we're gay? That's a bloody outing again, aren't we?
Gay.
Do we know our game, as in G-A-M-E?
It's in pheasants and rabbits.
Yeah. Do we know our game?
Oh, I need Wilson here for this one. He's all over that sort of stuff.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
Right, okay, so everybody out in Radio Land, in Mixcloud Land, in YouTube Land, in Listen Again Land, get a piece of paper, get a pencil, get a piece of cardboard, get your tablet, get a chalkboard, whatever your preferential.
Need some bloody tablets after this.
Thing is.
Okay.
And let's go. Question one.
And I've done multiple choice because I know, Neil, you like the multiple choice.
It's not a case of like it, it's the only way I can actually get anything right.
Okay, are you ready? Question number one.
Yeah.
The expression back to square one is. Can I start again?
Sounds like the ice cream van's down there, doesn't it? Just a whippy, get a flake, please.
Right, question number one.
Yeah.
The expression back to square one is believed to come from which board game? Is it A, Snakes and Ladders? Yeah. Is it B, Monopoly? C, Battleships? Or D, Connect Four.
Okay, I think we've got that one. Steve, you got an answer?
I think we have. We'll
perfect.
See if Sandy and Leo know as well.
Oh, is Sandy and Leo playing?
They're playing. Well, hopefully they're listening.
Everybody playing at home, get playing. Okay, question two.
Okay, right, question number two. With me, 2 seconds.
I think I might have a good chance of getting some right.
She's going to get an ice cream, isn't she? I can hear the ice cream van.
These bells. I just need to sort out these bells.
Go and shoot the campanologists.
Yeah.
We've got our own bells. Listen.
Question number two. Stop dinging that, Neil. Right. In Monopoly, what colour are Bow Street, Marlborough Street and Vine Street?
Yeah,
got that.
Are they A, green, B, blue, C, orange, or D, pink?
Okay. I'm confident.
This is better than sausages, this
isn't
one.
It?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
Question number three. In the game of backgammon, I can see you, Neil.
What?
We need to get this one right.
Okay.
In the game of backgammon, how many counters does each player have at the start? Is it A, 20, B, 15, C, 16, or D, 18?
I think that's above my pay grade, backgammon.
Andrea and I played a lot of backgammon, but we play sporadically, so we quickly learn the rules again and then play manically and then don't play for years.
And you have to relearn the rules again.
But
I'm like that with poker.
Yeah.
I love playing poker. Oh, what's this?
Neil and I love playing poker.
Yeah.
I have to come around and play poker.
Absolutely.
We've
got a poker table.
Have you?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, we've got all the chips.
We'll bring it round for the barbecue thing. Poker party.
poker party.
Okay, go again, sorry. Question four.
Right. English musician Andy Ernest Pratt was the inventor of which board game? Is it A, Logo, B, Cluedo, C, Articulate, or D, Catan?
Oh.
I'm not Googling this, I just had a WhatsApp. I'm just going to take a stab.
I know what it isn't. Read those again.
What, the answers?
Yeah.
Is it Logo?
Yeah.
B, Cluedo?
Yeah.
D, Articulate?
Yeah.
Or D, Catan?
Okay. Question five.
Got that one wrong, I think.
Question number five. Which game was created by Canadians Chris Hanny and Scott Abbott?
No, this one.
Is it A, Scrabble, B, Risk, C, Guess Who, D, Trivial Pursuit?
Oh.
Dave, are you looking up on your phone there, what you're doing?
Me?
The answer.
No, my phone's here, let us off. I know the answer to that one, didn't they answer to B?
Oh.
But I do have many screens in front of me to tell me the answer anyway.
Yeah.
But there's no point cheating, is there?
No, absolutely. You're only cheating yourself.
Exactly.
Steve.
Yes.
Okay, question six.
Name the only move in chess in which a player moves two pieces in the same move. Is it A, kinging, B, queening, C, castling, or D, pawning?
Oh, Claire's not a piece called a dog in there.
Dog in?
Yeah.
I got that one. I'm quietly confident that I got 50% so far.
You're never quiet.
Neil, when I went through these, I was like, you've got to get 5 out of 5. If you don't, that's it.
Yeah. How many questions are there altogether?
6 out of 6.
Oh, is that it? Is that the end of the quiz?
I was going for a 7th one there.
Oh.
Right,
Right. Oh, okay. Well, I think I've got 3 out of 6. Maybe I've got 4 out of 6.
Yeah, I think I'm going for a cheeky 3.
Right, what are we going to do then? We'll have another piece of Glastonbury music, shall we?
Yeah, what are we going for? Well, you want to go for...
Should we have a bit of Fat Boy?
Fat Boy?
Have a bit of Fat Boy Slim, Andrea. Yeah, we'll hang up, and then I'll give you a ring after Fat Boy, and we'll get the answers.
Fat Boy Slim married to Zoe Ball?
He was.
Who's she married to now, then?
She's not.
Her
boyfriend killed himself, didn't he? She's gone out with some guy.
Is he dead as well?
No, he is now, yeah. No, seriously. Yeah, he did. Yeah, she went out with some, can't think what his name is. He went out with some bloke. She went out with some bloke and he's, yeah.
Yeah, she used to be married to Fatboy Slim because they used to live in Brighton.
Hmm.
And then they...
she still does.
Then they split up, but he still does down on the edge of Brighton, yeah.
So who's she married to now then?
Don't think she is.
I don't think she is. I think she's a singleton.
I think she is.
That could be a bone. If we need a tiebreaker... That's your tiebreaker right there.
Exactly.
Let's have a bit of Fat Boy Slim and we'll give you a buzz back in a minute, really.
Well, there you go. Fat Boy Slim there. We've been discussing still about people that are dead or alive. And
Fat Boy Slim's...
I can't find a tiebreaker.
Well, let's hope that one of us wins then.
I think so. We've had...
One of you's got to win.
Okay.
We have had precisely no answers online this evening, but her indoors, who's currently indoors, is playing. She's just WhatsApped me.
Oh, has she? Yes. What, Lizzie? Lizzie's playing, is she? So hello, Lizzie. She's playing. Watching us in the kitchen.
Up at this.
That's Mrs. Prout.
Indeed.
I mean, there might be people playing, they just haven't bothered sending their answers in.
Yeah,
of course,
that's true,
people will be listening again.
There are people on Mixcloud, there are people on Phluid Vision, but...
There are people on Twitch.
They're not playing with us this evening.
No.
Let's
I don't care.
No.
Okay, so are you ready for your answers?
Yes.
Okie dokie, so here we go. Question number one.
Yes.
The expression back to square one is believed to come from which board game? What did you put down?
We went A.
Snakes and ladders.
Snakes and ladders, and you're correct.
As did the lovely Lizzie indoors. She's got
okay.
One point.
Okay.
Leo.
Question number two. In Monopoly, what colour are Bow Street, Marlborough Street and Vine Street?
Without even getting the answers.
Orange. Same as your t-shirt, Steve.
Yeah, a bit of a clue there. Another point for Lizzie.
Question number three.
This is where it starts going wrong.
Neil, in the game of backgammon, how many counters does each player have at the start?
20.
Is it, 20, B15, C16 or D18?
20.
I went 16, Lizzie went 26.
I think it's 20.
Well, guess what? I actually got this one right, Neil. It's 15.
Oh, would it be an odd number? That doesn't make
knickers.
Sense.
I was trying to count them up because you put five on the one spike, three on another spike, five on another.
See, I'd never go for an odd number on those sort of things.
No. Oh, okay, never mind.
Well, I worked it out and I thought, well, it's got to be an odd number, so.
Yeah. Well done.
Yeah.
Even Sandy's not playing, or Leo, or no.
It's not captioning her attempts like the sausage quiz last week.
I like this. Do you know your game?
Yeah.
Was the inventor of which board game? Was it A, Logotes, B, Cluedo, C, Articulate, or D, Catan?
I know it's not Catan because that's Klaus Tuber, because we've got that, we play a lot of Catan.
I wrote that down wrong. I put B. It's not going to be Cluedo, is it? Lizzie's put Logo.
I think it's Articulate, C.
Okay, the answer is Cluedo.
Oh!
I got it right by mistake.
I got it wrong. Right by mistake. You got it right for all the wrong reasons.
No, I just wrote down B. I thought I saw something different. Never mind. I'm taking it. I'll take that.
Have you got three?
I got three.
What did Lizzie put?
Logo.
Oh. You're storming ahead. What's question five then?
I got that one wrong as well. I put Catan.
No, that's Klaus Tuber.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Plays a mean brass instrument.
Question number five. Which game was created by the Canadians, Chris Hanny and Scott Abbott? Is it A, Scrabble, B, Risk, C, Guess Who, or D, Trivial Pursuit?
Got to be Trivial Pursuit.
I put Risk.
No, it's Trivial Pursuit.
Bloody hell, Steve.
Elizabeth Scrabble.
And I know I've got the last one right, so I've got three.
See, I wanted that.
You should know this, Steve.
Yeah.
Name the only move in chess in which a player moves two pieces in the same move. Is it A, kinging, B, queening, C, castling, or D, pawning?
Not dogging.
I think B, queening, is what Elton John does on.
And that's what I put.
It's castling, C.
Little queer.
It is. You are right. It is.
Oh,
castling.
Yes.
This is for pawning. She's got two out of six. Shocking. Must try harder.
What got four.
What did Lizzie get?
Two.
Lizzie's got two. That's Mrs. Prout. I got three.
Steve got four. Hey. No tiebreaker required.
No, like Phil Collins.
Yes. That's a jacket, wasn't
it? Yeah, it was. Oh, that was a good one.
I like that one in the end.
I like that one. But clearly, I only know 50% of my game.
I was still waiting if it would just be about pheasants and rabbits, personally, because it's that sort of different sort of game.
I got three.
Three.
I got snakes and ladders, orange, and
Mr. B got four, Mrs. B got two, and Mr. W got three.
Yeah, I got snakes and ladders, Monopoly, and castle and chess. And
nobody else has said what they're doing.
I should have got the backgammon one.
You should have done. I don't play them.
I'm shocked and horrified. Is that Benny Hill? Is he dead?
He's long dead.
I'm shocked and horrified that I got that backgammon question wrong.
Considering it's the only game we've actually played together.
Well, we do, yeah, I mean, poker and Catan and backgammon, really. But backgammon, we only play, yeah, nobody else apart from me and Andrew plays.
Never played it.
Steve, do you want to have a night playing poker?
That does sound a plan, doesn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
And the chips. Poker table.
Cracking. He's got a poker face.
Red padded leather around. And then we've got bags and bags of silver cases full of chips.
11.5 gram casino weight official chips, I'll have you know.
Can you cash them in with the cashier at the end?
Yeah, you can cash them in with us at the end. Well, we normally play Texas Hold'em.
Yes, it's easier, isn't it?
I mean, I've played shotgun, double-barrel shotgun, stud. You can play, but Texas Hold'em's quite a good one. It's quite easy. It's a semi-open game.
Yes. Yeah.
No, but we'll have to do that.
Yeah. Poker night is a plan.
Yeah, absolutely. Prout's poker.
Shall we have
party?
Some more music? So I'm discussing our social lives on air.
Thank you.
Such as they are.
Thank you very much for the quiz, Ready.
That was good.
You're very welcome. I can open the door now because I've nearly melted.
Brilliant. And I'll see you later when I get in.
No, unless... I will be in bed. Hey, did you tell Steve what you had to do this morning?
Oh, yeah, so I got up this morning and there's no sign of dogs running around, curtains open, Andrea and nothing. Slept straight through alarm and late for work.
Oh, absolutely. They should have rung the bells for you outside,
absolutely.
Shouldn't they?
They should have done. Well, they don't bloody ring them at the right time.
No, they need to. Neil's wide awake.
I'll have a word with the vicar and get him to ring them at 7 in the morning.
Exactly. Yeah,
I'll show you my man. I would have slept through them.
Oh, I know, zonked.
It's hot weather.
Too much booze. Oh, yeah, it's the hot weather. Yeah.
Because you have to drink a lot with not weather. That's like what it is.
Right, sweetie, I'll catch you in the morning.
It's the time for a tipple.
Oh, we're doing tipple of the week after this one.
See you later. Cheers. Bye bye. This is a very appropriate track. This is All Goes Wrong.
Jason Statham.
Yeah, not Jason Statham.
No, not a Poundland version.
Not a Poundland version. No, the proper version.
I like that quiz.
Sandy's been on. She didn't play along with us on the screen, which is a little bit.
See.
You know, we can't really trust this.
Well, I mean, you
three
can't.
3 out of 6.
Can't have, well, same as me.
Yeah.
Can't have that, though. I mean, you either play or you don't play.
Well, exactly. Exactly, yeah.
Play or don't play.
What is time for? It is Tipple
of the Week! This...
Not quite as good as the real version.
This shouldn't even be Tipple of the Week, because you quite rightly said earlier, you can't get this.
Here we go.
Oh, a bit of Oktoberfest.
Yeah, in June. So I shouldn't shake this one, really.
No, absolutely not. Christ, no, I think that's under pressure already. So,
Tipple. We've got some misbranded glasses there as well. One Stella one to see.
Do you want a Stella one?
The goblets.
Stella goblet.
Goblets.
So this, guys and girls and Steve, is Hawkstone Lager. As brewed by the fantastic Mr. Jeremy Clarkson. And as Steve says, you can't get hold of it.
No. The F1 teams. Team Alpine has it all at the moment. 4.8%.
They don't have it all, though, do they?
No, we've got two of them. We should auction them off.
We should do. They're worth about 50 quid each at the moment.
Got to be, haven't they?
Now, hewn from the mineral-rich bedrock of the Cotswold Hills. Now,
over
the week...
It should do it Jeremy Clarkson style, should it, really?
It's hewn from the mineral-rich bedrock of the Cotswold Hills.
There you go.
The Hawkstone, a Neolithic standing stone which gives our lager its name... has stood for generations. All of a sudden, I brewed a thing.
Very good.
But we were up in the Cotswolds over the weekend, hence we've got the Hawkstone Lager, because we were up helping to build a wall with our son-in-law, Tom.
We should use bricks, really, shouldn't you?
What, instead of lager?
No, instead of your son-in-law. What, your son-in-law?
And apparently he's still out admiring it today.
Is he?
Yeah. So we did some block work.
Yeah.
Tom said, can you come up and show me how to do basic block work or brick work? And I said, of course I can. But you can probably do it on YouTube. And he's like, yeah, but it's basically just an excuse to get together and have a drink and we'll do
this
building.
Just don't do the brick work after you've had a drink.
So straight away we phoned Paul and Joey Squance. Obviously we've already mentioned them on the show.
Why
we said, well, because basically Squance, he loves a project and he loves drinking. And Joey and Joey loves watching Paul do a project and drinking. Andrea loves watching me do a project and drinking. And Tom likes drinking and so does Fiona.
There's a bit of a theme here, isn't there?
There is.
Not building
and walls. Believe it or not, on the first day, after we got three quarters of a way around this wall, we knew we'd had a few. We started
to get slightly worse.
We started building at 9:30 in the morning, then we started drinking at 10. And we were drinking this.
Yeah.
Pipeline Pilsner, which will be featured as a Tipple of the Week moving forward. Mad Goose, which will be featured as a Tipple
Actually,
of the Week.
Actually, were Mad Geese after that.
Korev.
Oh.
Yeah. So
bit of an export up to there.
We had quite a lot of drinks. But this says here, the Cotswolds' harsh soil and brash soil in which it rests is hard and unforgiving.
You know about this, don't you?
We absolutely know, because we had to use a breaker bar to put the foundations in for this little wall because we couldn't get through the bloody soil. So it is hard and unforgiving. But for those who persist, that was us.
You got persistent, didn't you?
We did get persist. We did get persist. it yields. Yeah, it was almost at the point where it's like, is that brick level? It's level enough.
It's another
beer.
It do. Yeah, good enough for government.
It yields malting barley of unusually high quality, ideal for brewing. After harvest, our master brewer painstakingly and meticulously combines the barley with select hops, yeast, and the purest water possible before allowing it to mature for up to 6 weeks, during which time it develops its distinctive clean flavour. And it says it's easy to drink. I can also testify.
Okay, I've not tried it. I've not. So he's gone to Mike.
Shall we? Have you got a bottle opener?
I haven't.
I've got this one.
I've normally got. No.
I think you should do the honours then, Steve.
Badly prepared in here. You would think someone would be listing us all and bring us one in, wouldn't you? But they're
so
clearly not.
So is it going to be unyielding like the Cotswold soil, or is it going to be boisterous and rambunctious like Clarkson himself?
I think it's going to be a Clarkson-esque.
Let's have a listen.
Oh,
it's a semi. It's on the back to Elton again.
I can't work this thing. Oh, blimey, that's it. You have a go. I couldn't. That's
it. You just
try and get a better response on the mic than me.
You literally just get that and just go.
Ooh.
the little devil.
That's a cheeky one, that is.
That was a very cheeky one.
That's a very cheeky one. Andy's in the chat room. Sandy and Andy.
Oh.
Just need Mandy and somebody
else. And Randy.
And Randy.
Chin Chin. Let's have a pour and a sniff.
Let's have a pour and a sniff.
The only two that aren't with the Formula One racing team. I mean, yeah. Tom did say to Squanty, who did you have to kill to get this?
Esteban Ocon, their driver, probably.
Now,
what are we getting?
Let's have a go.
What's it supposed to smell like?
Oh, do you know what? It just
smells like lager.
but you know when you get lager and it's crap lager?
Oh, yeah.
And I'm going like Carlsberg. Yeah. Oh, here comes a dog.
You're too late now.
Oh, what have you got?
Bottle opener.
Oh, that's like a big version of mine.
Miles behind. You can't get the staff these days, it would seem.
If we'd have known we were going to get a bottle opener,
we'd have waited.
We'd have called for one.
Did a simultaneous decanter.
Look at the head on yours.
I know.
What a feisty fella. we'll be into the plums in a minute. But
cheers.
It's lager time of year, and you get crap lagers. But this, let's have a go.
That is refreshing.
Isn't it lovely?
That is nice.
It is. I'm in a lager glass as well, because we're in the misbranded Stella wife
beater
indeed. Glasses.
Yeah, the wife beater.
The only shame of this beer is it's a little 330.
Yeah, that's why I didn't bring pint glasses in. Would have been a bit lost. But that is nice. I said to you before, I'm not a lager drinker. But I've been sort of persuaded to go on to Korev recently.
Yeah, that's a nice one.
I used to do San Miguel to absolute death back in the day. We used to work in a place opposite a tapas bar. We'd get a tray brought across every Friday night. And then we stay for a week near San Miguel in Spain, and you just drink it all the time.
Yeah.
But this is, I like this.
But it's lager. When you get into the summer, I get into that kind of lager vibe. Mm. Estrella's another lovely one.
Yeah, yeah.
And the, which will be another tipple of the week moving forward, is the Pipeline Pilsner, which is brewed down by Johnny at Pipeline.
Yeah, yeah.
Next time I see you, remind me to give you a couple of Pipeline Pilsners, because it is absolutely banging.
No, I'm not.
But yeah, I mean, I'm a beer IPA.
Yeah, yeah.
But I recently got into cider, and I think sometimes the weather, you know, you sit with
Oh, there's weather. It's weather for it. It's the weather for cider, for sure.
It's the weather for cider. It's the weather for a shandy.
It's a weather for drinking. There you go. No, my
but
son loves
everywhere.
Cider.
That's
loves
all
cider.
Weathers.
Well,
I mean,
true.
If it's cloudy and thunderous, you get a nice bloody stout on the
yes.
go.
Yes.
In at winter, get a nice fruity plum stout or something like that. We'll have a bit of fruity plum nonsense.
We've got some fruity plum at the moment. what music we've got? We had a track.
Well,
to
we,
come
we
off
do
this,
because
we? Where were we?
Joey's brother,
yes,
Uncle Big Al.
Big
that's,
Al.
That's technically not his real name. His name's just Alan, but he goes
Al.
By the name of Uncle Big,
big
Al.
Big up to Big Al.
Had and this is a shame because it's absolutely fantastic. He had a band called Shirley. Don't call me Shirley.
Surely not.
Yeah, surely not. Surely he did. And he did us. And as we always do with Tipple of the Week, wherever it comes from, we try and find a band that's come from that area. Well, Uncle Big Al's from the Cotswolds. Let's play a bit of heavy love while we do a bit of heavy drinking.
Why, surely?
Surely not.
I tell you, sometimes the off-air chat's more interesting than the on-air chat.
Ah, well.
Which I'm sure most listeners will probably agree with.
Well, our on-air chat, I think.
Where did we get to?
We got halfway through a Hawkstone.
Oh, yes, we did, didn't we?
Yeah, yeah, and it's very good. And we were just saying, because that's Joey's brother, Uncle Big Al, in the band Shirley from the Cotswolds.
That's good. I've not heard a lot of these tracks tonight. You are enlightening me.
I'm all over my new music,
Steve. You are, aren't you?
Yeah,
I always am.
Yeah. Absolutely. What do you mean?
Down with the kids.
Absolutely.
Not in a Schofield sort of way.
But there's some great music. I mean, this is the shame of it. We are championing the fact that it's Glasgow this weekend. But also, saying off-air with the off-air chat, it's a shame that Glastonbury don't give some of the bigger stages to some of the newer music, isn't it?
Couldn't you almost do like a little lottery? So yeah. if you're like a... Let's say you've got 50 small bands there. I say, okay, you've got some gaps in between the big acts. Because, to be fair, people aren't going to sit around the pyramid stage watching you play if you're a little band. But if you're in between,
yeah,
like the warm-up maybe, or
yeah,
in between
the
big acts.
Like the Foo Fighters did with their road
crew.
Exactly,
yeah. Just where Elton comes on, have some decent bands.
Well, I mean, this is the thing. You know, if you haven't seen Bloody Guns and Roses and Elton John now, tough shit,
done.
Too late.
Done. Yeah, and that goes for a lot of these older acts on
you
here.
Should have already seen them.
I mean, Rick Astley. Oh. What's that about?
No.
He should have given it up, shouldn't he?
Yeah. Well, they did say that Rick Astley would make a fantastic politician because he's never going to give up.
Yeah,
he's
never
going
to down.
he's never going to desert you.
Bloody wish he would.
But yeah, that's not a bad idea, because I remember the Foo Fighters, and it was a while ago, and he said, Grohl came on the stage and said, before we play, you're going to listen to this other band.
Yeah.
It was their guitar tech and their drum tech, and they're a band in their own right. And he said, you know, we feel that you need to... They're not just our techies that come on and do this. They are a band, and they're going to come and support us.
Exactly.
And
they
I think
start somewhere, haven't they?
Absolutely. And you're right. You know, you get these old bands and they wheel them back out again. But some of the up and coming bands and some of the independent bands are so good that they do. You're right. Nobody's going to go to the main stage and go,
they're not.
Let's go and see.
No. Combustion. Even if they're on half hour before, they're going to go, oh, we'll wait till the main act comes on.
But at
there's
some point,
cracking small bands out there.
I always say when people, the worst thing that anybody says is like, you know, oh, I went to a pub and there was a local band in the pub and they weren't bad actually. As
yeah.
Like, well, what
not
do you mean
be
they,
rubbish, are they?
No, what do you mean though they weren't bad actually? What's that supposed to mean?
Yeah, because you expect it to be rubbish. But I did that piece for the Cornish Times a few months ago, and there's so many small bands out here. And if you go and speak to them after, and they're the best ones to speak to because when they've done their gig, they can have a drink at the bar with you.
Absolutely.
And you chat to some of these guys, not unlike yourself, and they'll suddenly start regaling you with these tales. Oh, yeah, I used to do a session with so-and-so, I met Bowie, and all this stuff comes out of them.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's not just about their music, it's about their backstory.
Absolutely.
They could have been there all but this, and...
Yeah, it's great. There's
fucking acts out there.
Ben Howard, he's gone massive now, hasn't he? Ben Howard, global massive star. I saw him with Anthony, my stepson, down at Falmouth Pavilions years ago, supporting Xavier Rudd, and Ben Howard came out, and he's got an interesting way of playing the piano. He sits it flat on the piano, his guitar, he sits it flat on his, he's got an interesting way of playing the piano, Steve, because he plays the guitar
under his arm.
And he kind of plays, like taps it and plays it, and then he had this girl sat behind him called India. She was on the cello. And
I thought it was going to be piano then.
And it was no, she was on the cello. And it was a really great set. And afterwards, you're absolutely right. So we were just down at Falmouth Pavilions, and he comes out into the little green bit. Anthony and I went over and said, "What a brilliant set! Absolutely fun." And he was chatting. He's a Falmouth lad.
Yeah.
And he was having a right old chit chat. And I thought, crikey, now look at him. He's a trailblazer, Steve.
This is it. And they got to start somewhere. I don't think they get the breaks that the old established bands got. Elton John got his break. The Beatles got the Stones got their break.
Yeah.
I don't know, they obviously worked hard for it, but a lot of these ones now, the musicianship of these people, the singing of them, the craft.
It's good, isn't it? And also should mention, get down to the Bullers next Friday, the 30th of
the
June,
Bullers.
Because Mellow Doubt are down at the
good.
Bullers.
They are good.
They played at JJ's...
A few months ago now, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. But absolutely fantastic. And literally, they only got halfway through their set, and Jamie, bless him, was already got the diary out to book it back in again.
I thought he was going to say halfway through, and it all kicked off down there.
No, but it was a good full crowd. And then they're down at the Bullers on, as I say, next Friday the 30th. So great
get
pub.
Down there.
Great team down there. Yeah, get down there and have a listen to Mellowed Out.
If you want to see the gig guide, well, you've missed it for this month, but it's all, you cut it out and keep it from the paper, don't you, the gig guide?
Absolutely.
Every single
I put my heart and soul into that gig guide.
We've seen. Yeah, it's good. It is good.
Yeah.
A lot of heart and soul in that gig guide.
Just a little bit of heart and soul.
She was on Twitter today moaning about her gas and electric bills.
Was she on Twitter moaning about the photographer who was up at the Exeter Phoenix 3 weeks ago taking photos
actually.
Of her?
She thought, she said, yeah, she said, this is good. Like Jason Statham taking my photograph.
I thought it was a transporter. Another shout out, though, Steve, to another band that are playing at Glastonbury that have been.
Indeed.
One of Leo's friends, actually, Elle The Pocket Belles. He knows them very well, doesn't he?
Well, let's have a bit of that show. It's called Golden Sound.
We don't know what this sounds like, do we?
No, but it is. It's a remix. So, hey, we're going to.
This could be hit or miss.
It could
Steve.
Be. I'm sure it'll be a hit. Oh. There's been no misses thus far this evening, apart from the score and your score on the quiz.
No, that was awful, wasn't it?
That's terrible. Let's have some of this.
Start the gramophone, pull something out of the blue. I bring that dial to the start, spinning it all the way through. Hear that tune, let it take you there, and get yourself into the mood. And don't be scared to use what's there, you never know what you might do. We found the golden sound, mixing the old with the bass. What goes around, comes around, we found the sound of the day. Turn it up, feel the love, spin it around all the way. Cause the sound that we found goes around and around and it keeps going.
The golden sound we wanted you to hear.
Out of the blue, bring that dial to the start, spinning it all the way through. And hear that tune, let it take you there, and get yourself into the mood. And don't be scared to use what's there, you never know what you might do. Cause we found the golden sound, mixing the old with the bass. What goes around, comes around, we found the sound of today. And turn it up, feel the love, spin it around all the way. Cause the sound that we found goes around and around, and it ain't ever going away.
The golden sound we wanted you to hear.
Squashy eggs, that's what I got.
I keep trying to touch screen my laptop. It's not a touch screen, I've got a mouse set.
Just saying, everybody out there, this Hawkstone Lager, to me, seems to have one of those sort of... lingers on the palate, as
it
Alan
does.
Partridge
it
says, like a lazy forklift driver.
Doesn't it's welcome, does it?
Lingers on the palate, like a lazy forklift driver.
Someone keeps putting that Dan clip on Twitter. Maybe we've seen the car park shot to Dan. Dan! Dan! Yeah, half an hour of him shouting. Yeah. Oh, he's not listening.
That's brilliant.
It's the story of our life on here,
absolutely
isn't it?
Brilliant.
Dan! Where did we get to?
It's got that oak matured, like it, when they say it's made in a sherry cask or it's made in a whiskey cask. Yeah, and then Steve saying that for Father's Day. What did you say? You've got a single...
single malt, Jura, 15 year old it was.
And that's
a whiskey. We're out on John again, aren't we? 15 year olds. Not mentioning Schofield.
Poor Rolf.
Yeah. He's down in
Mrs. Squashy eggs. You know what squashy eggs are. So, you know, what's it called?
Pickled eggs?
No, they're sweets.
Like a pickled egg?
They're sweets. They're like the foam
flumps.
White.
We know them as flumps, like marshmallowy.
Like that flump. Things. Yeah, but yeah, then you've got the what's the company? Haribo. The company. So they're like an egg. So that bit's yellow, and that's like a flumpy material. Oh, yeah. And then so I got some of them.
A bag of Haribos, basically.
No, you have a box of Bonds.
A box of Haribos.
Because eggs, Fiona, my stepdaughter, she knows that eggs are my favourite.
Yeah.
So she specifically got a box from Bond Street or something. Ooh. They're posh.
Yeah, I'm cheap. Not saying they weren't posh.
I'm not dissing you. You're dissing my squashy eggs.
And swallow.
Back to Elton again.
Get to
squashy eggs. So, they're posh.
They're posh eggs.
They're not a single malt, but they're a single
quail
young.
Eggs.
Yeah, they are squashy
from
quail
swans.
Eggs. Yeah. And I got a chocolate orange.
Oh.
And Josephine and Louis made a lovely big chocolate cake.
Oh.
As well, which was
good. And eggs. What's more to like on a Father's Day?
Absolutely. And allegedly, Anthony said he's got some alcohol for me somewhere. He's probably drunk that now.
Can't go wrong, can you?
Well, it was last weekend, Stephen.
It was.
I haven't been round to collect it, so when I go round, he's probably already drunk it.
Error that, isn't it? Schoolboy error there.
I know. I should have gone straight away, shouldn't I, when I got home?
Really?
And recovered my. Now.
Never mind.
This will be disingenuous because Lizzie's got us on in the kitchen and she's provided us with some additional tipples.
Yes.
We've got
some shot glasses.
I'm going to leave you to decide what we do and in which order we.
I can't make it. This almost sort of says Blackberry on this.
I think that's
it?
Petrol.
I think it's a Molotov cocktail. Just stick a rag in this and light it.
Hang on.
It does say Blackberry.
Oh, four-star.
Four-star.
Yeah.
It's not super unleaded. It looks like it.
Blackberry 11:33.
I think 11. That's
apple and blackberry.
It's a crumble. It's a crumble in a glass.
What's the 11:33 and 2.99 and 5?
I don't know. Probably the gravity.
113%.
That's the one. Yeah, don't spill it on the desk. It'll take the paint off. Ah.
Are we going to have a look at this?
I think so. I think we need to. We need to have some decent.
What are we having? Oh.
Professionals.
Ooh. Shall we have a nosy as well? Let's just have a finger.
I beg your pardon. He's back to bloody Elton again, isn't he?
God, a finger each.
A finger of fudge.
Do you remember a finger?
Just enough to give a kiss a treat.
I mean, you couldn't get away with that now, could you?
Well,
surely not.
Certain TV celebrities probably could.
Well.
They probably have been fingering a fudge. Now, anyway. We'll have a little
Let's have a finger.
Is it a sousson, you call it? Is that
Yeah. That's fingerish enough. You can have two fingers because you're not trying.
I'll be bloody three sheets and my two fingers after this one. It's not quite sure what this is, but anyway. It's made by my brother-in-law, Mr. Plucker. And if that's not a good...
I'm not quite sure this is.
I can have my fingers now. Right, let's just dispatch that somewhere.
I mean, it looks like it's had a good seeing to.
We've got his pinky out there, that's a good sign.
Oh.
What's it smell?
I was going to say, actually, let's have a nose, but let's not.
Can't remove your hairs off your nose if you hadn't, wouldn't it?
What are you going in? Are you going back in a wanna?
Ah, bugger it. Jesus Christ! What is that?
I'm getting blackberry though.
Oh yeah.
Mm. Are you not?
I can't taste anything.
I'm not quite sure
that.
What it is.
It's
though.
It's a palate cleanser.
Is it a wine? Is it a?
It's not like a liqueur, isn't it? That is very much.
Actually,
you wouldn't want much of that.
But now, roaming around the mouth, as we say.
There we go.
That has got some flavour.
That's not bad.
That's not actually as bad as I thought that was going
to
be.
No. Shall we go on to the other one?
Shall we?
I don't know what's in the other one.
I don't know.
Well, we told it was plum, wasn't it?
Oh, it was your brother-in-law's plums.
Mr. Plucker's pickled plums.
Oh, a bit of brothers in arms.
Yeah.
I'm getting some nice... I'm getting apple now.
I'll get you a crate of it if you want. You can't get rid of it. Oh, there's a bit of a cunt.
That's
in
a
that
fat
one.
Finger, that is.
Jesus. Oh, crap.
Oh, Christ.
Right.
That's not bad.
That's not a bad colour, is it?
No.
Oh,
what's this
name? That's a bit licorice. Look at that. You see, you're supposed to check the legs out on it.
How are you? Okay. Andrea will know all about that. She does that with wine and she'll say it's got legs on it.
You can see on the side of the glass.
Yeah, has it got legs?
It's starting to take the glass off of it.
It's polishing the glass.
It is, isn't it? Yeah.
Has it got legs?
Yeah, it's a little bit.
Does it? It's like ZZ Top?
Yes, with less beard, thankfully.
It's got legs. He's dead.
Oh, no. There's Andrea. She knows all about legs.
Hang on. Hello?
We should wait for Neil to come back from his phone call to...
Oh no, it's only this is only fruit juice. I'll be fine. I can still hear those bells. Okie dokie, darling, catch you later.
Bye.
That's Andrea saying that I've got to drive home. But this isn't strong stuff. We're only...
Oh no, it's not.
No. And we're literally having a tiniest.
You wouldn't want a full glass of this, let alone a bottle of it.
It's not spirits.
No. We've got to say that probably it's wine, isn't it?
But, yeah, and it's, you know. and that's actually more fruity.
Yeah, this is, I'm not sure if it's creosote, I think.
Let's have a try.
I don't think it's going to be as nice as this one. Jesus Christ. Tastes like ink.
It does taste like plums, though. Are you getting plums?
I suppose. Burnt ones.
Yeah.
So burnt
plums.
Yeah. Alan Plum's brother.
Alan Plum's burnt plums.
Burnt plums. Yeah, I'm not sure.
No.
Right.
I think the less said about
moving on.
Moving swiftly on.
What can we have?
Ooh. I quite like that Elle The Pocket Belles that we just played there. That was a remix.
Can't play it again.
No.
Well, we can do. We can play it. We'd like to play it all evening if you want.
But I'm just saying it was very... There was a song out a while back from Gramophonedios.
Yes.
It was very much... My plums are repeating.
Oh, don't want your plums repeating. What are we going to have? It's just Sparks. They're weird, aren't they?
They were weird.
They're still
the one
weird.
Looked like Hitler.
They did, didn't they? And his brother got big curly hair.
Yeah.
And so one of them...
What have you got? This town ain't big enough for the both of us.
So it's the male... They're called the male brothers, aren't they? Well, clearly they're males because they're brothers.
Yeah. I think one of them's dead, honestly. I do. And I'm going to Google it while we're
going to play
there.
Dead or Alive. Yeah. Well, not Dead or Alive, because he's dead.
Oh, he's dead. Well. Dead or Alive, he burns. He is dead.
He died while I was in Spain once.
Actually, the bloke,
he wasn't in Spain with me.
And also, I think Divine... Who was about
walk like a man.
He's dead.
Yeah.
I think.
He's definitely dead.
I'm going to look up Sparks.
This has got legs. And the wine as well. Let's have some of this. Oh, bit of falsetto from Wal there.
This town ain't big enough for the both of us.
They are, as we were just discussing off air, a properly odd group, Ron and Russell May.
Well, they are both still alive, but they are in their 70s.
And they do look odd. I mean, certainly, if you Google... just Google the band, and you'll see... It's Ron, isn't it, the weird-looking one?
That was released in 1974.
Crikey. I was 2 years old then.
Bloody hell.
That's terrible. Scary, isn't it?
Yeah.
That'd be a good set, I reckon. Catch what you can at Glastonbury, because it'd be all over the BBC, wouldn't it? They seem to have a franchise on...
It's normally gigs at the moment. It's normally quite good if you can pick and choose on the red button.
Yeah, that's the best way to watch it.
Yeah.
I mean, you know... Put your feet in a bucket of mud if you want to get the full experience.
Absolutely. And sleep in a tent in the sitting room.
And get someone to charge you £10 for a pint of beer.
That'd be great, but yeah.
It's not cheap.
Somebody stick the kettle on, I fancy a coffee. Yeah, that's a tenner, mate.
Yeah, exactly.
That's right, and then just get occasionally somebody just punch you in the face or something.
They tuck you up. I know you can't go once you're in there. They got you, haven't they? But they got you anyway.
Well, we're going to see Jack Johnson tomorrow, as I mentioned earlier in the show. And Andrea said... Do you realise we're going to get searched? And I said, yeah, you will get searched. She goes, I was going to take a bottle of wine and all sorts in. I said, you can't take a bottle of wine in. She's like, well, why not? I said, because they want to stitch you up.
Of course they do.
By selling you wine. She goes, well, can I not take a bottle of water in? I said, no, probably only if you're transgender, because then you can get away with anything.
Or gender fluid.
Or gender fluid, yeah.
Take a bottle of gender fluid in with that. I'll catch me out.
I did see something on Instagram the other day, which made me laugh, actually, and it was from Family Guy, which, as you know, is probably the least politically correct programme on that. And there's a guy sat at a bar, it's a bloke, and he's got a blonde wig on, and he's just going through his phone like this, and the barman comes over and he goes, no porn at the bar, sir. And he said, but I'm transgender. And he goes, sorry, I apologise. Do whatever you want all the time. And I thought, yeah, there you go.
It just about says it all, doesn't it?
Just about
the minorities are taking over.
But I've got a, you know, on the wall of, not the wall of Prouts, on Prouts Night Out, Steve.
I'm getting confused about where we are.
On Stephen Neil's World of Pain. You do Rants and Bants.
I do. It's getting copied. They say, don't they, imitation is a sincerest form of flattery.
I know.
I'm not going to flatter these people by saying who they are. However, they know who they are.
Yeah, people know who they are. They're trying to follow us to
exactly,
do what we do to
exactly.
get to the next level.
It can't
level.
Be done. It can't be done.
But I've got a rant, right? So the other day, you know the Tamar Bridge?
Yes.
You have to pay.
£2 flipping 60 to get to Cornwall. That's seven even.
Exactly that. So normally I go Shopping. And we've got a tag. And so you put your tag up. Oh, is it? Oh, very nice. Mine's a Casio. So I went over the other day, and I've got my works van, and it's not my regular works van, so it's a red. So I haven't got the.
It's an irregular van.
I haven't got the tag up or whatever. Yeah. But normally you put the window down, you hand them the tag, and they're like, "Thank you very much."
But you're a white van man, so they're going to take a Mickey off anyone, aren't they?
Yeah.
Really?
So I go through the tag only lane because I've got a tag, and everybody else is queuing up. Then, well, I go through the tag only lane because I've got a tag.
Yeah.
So right. You drive up to the bridge. I've counted this before, sad that I am. There's something like 32 signs as you go across
the
bridge.
Yeah.
When you get to the window in this lane, mate, you have to have your tag attached to the window. I'm like, okay,
does
which
really
of those
matter?
Which of those 32 signs
does it say that?
Says that. There's no information about it. You have to have your tag. Tamar Bridge Nazi.
Yeah.
You have to have your tag attached
Job's
to the
worth.
Window. Where's it say that, mate? No, you do if you come in this lane. All right. Well, it's not attached to the window because it's not my... Well, it should be. So I give him the tag.
Yeah.
He got no money on this because it's a work. So he got no money on
no.
this. Got no money on this tag. Got no money on this tag, mate. Oh,
you can't pay cash, I suppose. It's tag only.
And I said,
you think?
And I said, oh, never mind. I said, look, I said, I'll just pay. Because what can't you use in most places these days?
Yeah, cash.
Cash. I'll pay, don't worry, I've got a card. Don't take cards in the tag owner. I'm like, where have all these rules all
exactly.
of a sudden come from?
It's because
I'm just
they
trying
can.
To get over the frickin' bridge.
I know.
You're robbing me anyway.
You've got to, yeah.
You need
never
to pay
a nice
cash.
At Plymouth anyway.
Right, so I'm rooting around, I get my wallet out. Here's my wallet. And I'm like, right, okay, let's see if I've got some cash. Right, what
no,
cash
you
have I got?
Fully waiting.
Right, I've got 85p. Right, I've got a car, can't pay cards. Tag has to be firmly. I'm just like, do you know what,
all
mate?
The time, you're queuing up behind you saying, what's this idiot in front of the white man
doing? What is
this doing?
Yeah. So, right, so what does he do? He gets out a ticket thing like this, which is
I'll
a
have
receipt.
To charge you extra for that.
What I'll have to do is I'll print you. Right, guess what he calls it, though? I'll print you a violation ticket.
Oh, you violator. Back to
hell. Who have I violated? I'm literally just trying to get over the
You're
bloody
violating
bridge.
Violating the bridge.
Yeah, I'll make you a violation ticket, sir. Just wait there. What's the registration?
Right,
FDA. Yeah. So then he comes out with this receipt, right?
All the time, there's a queue behind you.
Yeah, bearing in mind, this is for £2.60. When you get home, then he starts talking me through the receipt. When you get home, there's a website address here or there's a phone number. You can phone this number. But if you don't do it within a certain time, you'll be fined, right? You've got 5 days to pay this violation ticket. Otherwise, it's £60.
What
random made-up figure is that for trying to get over the bridge?
That seems to be the standard price for any violation. £60, isn't it? Speeding thing, whatever, parking thing, £60. It just seems to be the standard these days. I mean, last time I went to Plymouth, went over there, one of our random bank holidays this year. I say my company's when it was.
It's made me grab hold of my plums again,
yeah,
Steve,
I
that random.
And went over there, I got a speeding ticket.
Really?
I hate going to Plymouth. For this reason, you get
and you got a speeding ticket
on the bridge, and it costs me £100 and a speeding awareness course to go to Plymouth. Speed,
well,
I'm aware of speed, yes, I do speed.
Speed kills.
Exactly.
Well, anyway, this ticket
Speed's
gets
fun.
This violation
you
ticket.
Violator.
I mean, I'm sure.
Violator.
I'm sure there's a custodial sentence somewhere
I'm
along
sure
the lines for trying. What were you doing, sir?
I was
literally at work, just trying to get over the bridge. You bastard!
Yeah, there's people in there who've murdered people.
So anyway, I get home and I input this website, and you go onto the Tamar Tag website. Violations. Pay ticket. £2.60 plus a £2.60 administration fee. Right, I'm doing all the work. Why am I paying a two when I've got to then go and
because,
do this? Then I've got
do.
To input the number, input my registration. Input, I'm doing all the work, and I've got to. So it cost me £5.20 with this violation ticket. And to top it all, you know, they've just put this new Bristol, sorry guys, everybody at home going like,
but, oh, the new
clean air,
that's the one.
60 quid. It is 60 quid. So it's £9 if you pay it. And our mate Charlie, our guitarist Charlie, he goes to Bristol a lot because he does a lot of work in Bristol. He got caught out and didn't realise that he'd clipped the violation zone. Yeah,
a lot of violations going on, isn't there?
So he then thinks, oh Christ, I was in the free air zone, I got to pay 9 quid. Gets a letter through the post. Because you've been in it and you haven't paid it within 2 days, is it?
Naughty boy.
It's a £60 fine. So Charlie then contests this.
Yeah, I would.
So there's a period of time where you can contest it. But because he didn't contest it within the time, and they didn't receive it, no, they said, you now owe us £120 because you didn't get it in the right time. But when he contested that, they added the original 60 quid and he had to pay them 180 quid. So you think about that.
To go to Bristol.
You've been to Plymouth. I tried to get over the bridge and Charlie's been to Bristol. They've had 180, 280... £5.60.
We're trying to go about our lawful business. We're not trying to do anything illegal here.
No, and you're £2. So they've had just under £300 for three working men to try and just go about their job to help pay taxes to support people that can't be asked to go to work.
Exactly.
Steve. That's what gets my ruddy goat.
Indeed. The weekly get my goat section with Neil.
But it's true though, isn't it?
No, it is.
Why is it 60 quid?
Because it is. Why is it speed awareness? The other thing.
Oh, speed awareness. I've done three of them, so it don't work.
No, exactly. But it used to be, didn't it, back in the day, right? Correct me if I'm wrong. You have to go to a hotel, didn't you, or a hall.
Yes.
We're paying 100 quid for this bloke to come out for the day, little jolly.
Yeah.
Provide the tea and the coffee and the biscuits.
Yeah, you get tea and coffee.
And sit here for 4.5 hours while he patronises you. Well, now I've got this. And I tell you what, like, it's like Fight Club these days, because you're not supposed to speak about it outside of the course.
No, you're not.
So I shouldn't say anything about this gentleman who did it from his parlour. And basically, this guy is sat in his front room with flying ducks behind him doing the speed awareness course.
Really?
In his pants.
Oh, online?
Yeah, online. So where's 100 quid go?
Well, government's pocket. Goes into the secret policeman's ball for
that. Exactly.
It is incredible, isn't it?
It's no point. There's no point working sometimes, is there? Because you think, actually, no. I've gone and done my day's work. I've got to go and bung this across to
100 quid to the thing.
Charlie for his fines, his plums. And
what have we got on your playlist that sums that up?
Oh, Lightning Seeds.
Oh, they're playing this weekend. Lightning Seeds. Seen them live years ago. Lightning Seeds.
The Life of Riley.
Oh well, we didn't have the Life of
that
Bloody
like the
Riley,
government
did we?
This country.
Gore, you villain, Steve.
Oh, yes, terrible. I won't be doing that again, though. They won't catch me next time.
Absolutely, and now that restraining order. Oh, sorry, we're back on them.
That does require a bit of bully.
Oh, doesn't it?
A bit of bully.
But you just saying about going over to Plymouth and getting...
I try not to.
Charging 100 quid to go to Plymouth. Right, Tom, he of the wall building over the weekend.
Yes. Is he joining Pink Floyd anytime soon?
No, he's rendered his bricks in the wall now.
Is he?
But he is in the RAF. He's stationed up at Bryce Norton, which incidentally my dad was stationed
up.
They
should repatriate all the troops, didn't they, and bring them into place.
Well, my dad was stationed at Bryce Norton when he did his national service, but that's not the story. He used to be, Tom, not my dad, in the Marines. And he was driving his car into Plymouth because he said, oh, I've got to insure my car. And I think at the time he was going to sell it. And he said he was going away. He was billeted away for 6 months, didn't need the car. And he said, I'm not going to insure the car for 6 months when I'm not going to use the car. So he phoned up the barracks, and the barracks said, look, if you want to bring it over, just park it. We know it's your car. Park it in the barracks.
Can't get away with that anymore. It's probably part of your story.
What, parking it in the barracks?
Parking it anywhere without... No, yeah, carry on.
Well, no, so they said, come and park it in the barracks because it's secure, and then it's off the road and it's...
That's probably government property anyway.
Exactly. So he drove over, and it was on the day that the insurance expired. He drove into Plymouth at some ungodly hour, like 3 in the morning, and just for some bizarre reason, got ANPR'd by a squad car.
Oh, no.
And instead of insuring his car, which would have probably cost him, I don't know, he got something like a £360 fine. He explained to them he was in the Marines, he was seconded for 6 months, he's taken into secure parking, and they said, that's as maybe, but we're the police, and here's your fine. And you're like, good God.
Do you not claim PTSD? No... Claim PTSD for most things these
days. It's like, well, you know, I hope when the country gets invaded, the Marines go, well, I'm not defending you, mate, because I've got something better to do. I haven't got any money to come out and put bullets in my gun, so you've got shot.
Exactly, yeah. The other thing that gets me, so I thought where that story's going to, if you've got a few vehicles, let's say, you've got to sawn them all.
Yes.
So back in the day, so is it, you're down here.
What does sawn stand for?
I wouldn't want to say.
Something
statutory off-road notice.
Off-road notice, right.
Statutory
okay.
off-road notice. Yes.
Oh, really nice.
Yes, they're all a bit going to add noise after the bit of weather the government. They all sound like that, don't they? Like an plum. So down here, it would make sense to have like a nice little sort of sporty car for the summer.
Yes, which you've got.
And a 4x4
which
when the weather
got.
Gets horrendous. Hmm. And you think, I could just park it on my driveway. Just not tax it.
Yeah.
Which is fine. But no, you don't tax it, don't show it, but you've got to sawn it.
Yeah.
You've got to go to them and say, it's off the road. Well, it's off the road, it's on my field.
Yeah.
It's on my driveway. Wherever it is,
I'm not going to drive it because I'll get a fine.
Anybody
because
else
I know that...
anymore.
Yeah.
And they then come to you, end of the whenever it is, oh, you've got that, that's done, you forgot that one there, for God's sake.
I know. And then you get a
what crime are we committing?
The crime of trying to do your job
and
try
and do the right thing. And I say to you just now, fair, people like flipping. Bojo,
yeah,
Muppet features, old Mr. Frizzy here. Oh, forgive me. Oh, sorry, I'm gonna forgive you.
Yeah,
that's all right, mate. Don't worry about £60 fine for breaking COVID.
Well, I was gonna say, and also don't worry about these things because if you get fined, you get the same fine as like a Premiership footballer and he's on £20 million quid
means
a day
test
or whatever.
It. Means test it.
And you're on your what you're on, £22 million quid a day.
But then to be fair, the people that do dodge their car tax probably ain't got any money anyway.
The problem is, though, that the police... this is what I always find with things like this, but, you know, we could go on forever ranting about this. So let's. So what will happen is, if they find a car, and let's face it, it's a battered-up old bloody, I don't know, Mark 6 Fiesta or something.
Exactly.
They're literally going to go...
No top, ball tyres.
Yeah, well, there's no point in taking him to court because he's clearly unemployed. He's not going to turn up at court
exactly.
and he's not going to pay.
No point taking the car, it's not worth anything.
With the nice Mercedes, we'll go and get him for something because we know he'll pay.
Yeah.
I know, it's wrong.
That is prejudice. That's prejudice.
It is.
That
it
is no
prejudice.
Different than them picking on a woman rather than a bloke or gender-fluidy person over
exactly.
a trans
exactly.
person.
So what I'm going to do is next time I get pulled over for speeding...
Could you self-identify something different?
Well, I'm going to identify as somebody who wasn't speeding.
You could do that.
Yeah.
Or he says non-speeder.
Yeah, if he says, I've caught you for doing that 60 and a 40, you were speeding, and I say, well, today, officer, I'm it's my right to identify, so I'm going to identify you as somebody who was driving within the speed limit.
Yeah, or say your dashboard identifies 60 as 40.
Exactly. So I wonder if we could get away with that.
That's existential, that is.
I bet we couldn't.
Well, we'll
but
try
you don't
it.
Know what it is. It's 9 o'clock.
Give it a go next week. And we'll see you in
court. Yeah, well, let's go razzing it through Plymouth and see who gets away with it.
Exactly.
Do you know what? Honestly, if I was minted and the parking warden was coming down our lane, I would just literally get my wallet out and go, right,
yeah.
There's 150 quid, mate. I'll leave it there for the week.
People
now,
do,
off.
Don't they? People do. People in London, you see these Lamborghinis and Ferraris and Porsches. These flipping rich Instagram kids. I don't understand these influencers.
Hey, we're on Instagram. Why aren't we driving around in a Lamborghini?
Exactly. You're not an influencer, apparently.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. No, so these influencers, they do exactly that. They park on doublers outside Harrods, for example.
Yeah.
I think, well, it's actually cheaper for me to pay 500 quid for the week.
And you leave it there.
Yeah. That is their
well,
parking
if you're running
ticket.
A Lambo, you can...
But, you know, I always thought when I've got those things on my windscreen, I parked really well. I said, parking fine.
Oh,
hey,
see
we're
what
here
you did
week.
There.
Right, we're going to finish. This guy's definitely
on that
dead.
Bombshell. Back to Clarkson, on that bombshell.
This guy's definitely dead, by the way.
He is, we Googled him.
Maxi Priest.
Is it Maxi Priest?
No, he's not Maxi Priest.
That's the wrong
Maxi
fella.
Maxi Jazz.
Is Maxi Priest dead?
Not the Honda Jazz.
No, good God, no. That should be dead.
God, dear mate. This is drivers normally are.
And thank you for tuning in to the Wal of Paine show.
Exactly. It's better than last week.
I think it's good.
I think hopefully normal order will be resumed in the Pandemonium Studios next week.
Premium prime time broadcasting.
Listening, viewing and whatever. Do remember to catch up again online. All stuff at Leo's. I can't remember what he says. It's
we're on Twitter at Steve Prout. We're on Instagram at Instagram at Phluid Records at //FB Records and feed the head of your...
What is that all about? I've never understood
that. I don't
know.
Feed the head of Ronald Reagan or something.
That's the one. Or do so to Biden.
Absolutely. Yeah. And don't forget to like, share, subscribe and...
He's all on point, isn't he?
And send us
there.
A postcard.
Yeah. But remember, we can't return any of your pictures.
We can't return any of your pictures.
And they're said by Rolf Harris. Oh, this has some Faithless.
Right, night.
See you next week. Bye for now.